Nestled quietly among the citrus groves in the middle of Florida is the city of Auburndale. This is where we met father, grandfather, Navy veteran, and former Bonatti Spine Institute guest, John Springer.
Right now, I'm in a state of semi-retirement. I deliver mail for a local community college that my wife works with, trying to help her get through to her final retirement date next year. And at that point in time, well, then we start life again. And that's how we intend to spend our years, just kind of enjoying each other, enjoying lots of grandkids, do some traveling. I love to hike, walk. We're getting ready to shift gears from the busy life of earning to the easier life of spending.
John shares stories of how a life spent working hard can sometimes take a physical toll.
I served in the Navy for 6 years, and then I also worked in the Navy Yards. Anybody who's ever been on a ship or submarine know that when you go through a hatch, you bend over. So you're not always walking straight up. You have valve handles in the way. So you're always ducking, dodging, assuming oddball positions. If you're carrying a valve over your shoulder, and some of these old valves that we used to have to take out of steam systems or what have you to repair, well, they would weigh 80, 90 pounds. You just tie a rope, throw it over your shoulder, bend over, and haul it up a ladder or whatever you had to do to get it off the boat. So that kind of stuff, you know, just takes its toll on your back and spine, dead on mine. One morning I woke up and could not reach my shoes. I couldn't get to my feet. My wife had to tie my shoes to get me ready to go to work. It was a challenge to my manliness to have my wife tie my shoes. I got to admit, it was a blow to my ego. And that was kind of the start of it. So I went to a chiropractor and they did all the spinal manipulations. I saw him for about a year. And it didn't make much of a difference. It helped, but it didn't make much of a difference. Moved to Florida shortly after that because they closed our Navy Yard in Charleston. So we ended up down here in Central Florida, started an air conditioning heating business, something nice and light like lifting air handlers through, carrying them through attics and big giant units in the yard. So I continued the abuse and continued to see the chiropractor, added on a massage therapist, even researched and did a year's worth of vertebral axial decompression, VAX-D. Everything helps a little bit. I owned every brace. I still have a drawers full of braces. They don't really do anything but help you stay erect while you suffer your pain and continue to do your work.
For decades, John dealt with his pain as best he could. When it finally became too great, he met with a surgeon who offered him a fusion surgery. Unhappy with this option, John took to his computer, knowing there had to be another way to find relief.
Initially, the pain was just in my low back, and it hurt to bend over. Like I said, I couldn't tie my shoes, but that was it. It was just pain in the back. The pain began to radiate down my left leg, which was a new experience for me. It's like an electrical shock that wants to hit you in the knees. It causes a great amount of discomfort when you get an electrical shock in your joints. Over a period of another year or so, it went all the way down to my foot. Then I was having the electrical shocks in the knees, in the foot, and then the bottom of the foot stayed nice and numb. Probably in the next year or so, pain started creeping down on the right side. Now, we're able to manage all this with all the different therapies that I was doing, you know, the massage and the chiropractic and what have you. We tried the opioids. Hydrocodone, oxycodone, none of that stuff really did anything. But it was basically just holding me off until I got with a surgeon, which I eventually did. I met a very fine fellow here in the Winter Haven area. He showed me this amazing contraption he was going to install in my back. Lots of shiny parts and pieces. And it scared me to death. In a state of panic and a state of extreme pain, I sat at a computer in 2006, and I started researching spine remedies. I didn't realize all the different things that were available worldwide for spine repairs, but there's a lot of really wacky stuff out there. I ran across a site for the Bonatti Institute. They had some videos and things. I thought, okay, here's somebody who wants to educate me. So I started watching the Bonatti videos. I read every word on every page. It just all made sense. It just made perfect sense. So I made a phone call, spoke to a lovely lady on the end of the line, and she said, well, if you just send us a copy of your MRIs, we can review those and have a surgeon call you the next day. I did get a phone call, and they said, yeah, I was a very likely candidate for the minimally invasive surgery, so we made an appointment.
Upon arrival at the Institute, John met with the Benatti team and discussed his surgical summary.
My first initial physical contact, saw a surgeon within an hour after arriving at the Institute, and he explained where my pain was, what it probably felt like, what the cause of it was, showed me everything on the MRIs. We performed a total of 5 surgeries in 2006, 7, and 8. All the pain was removed from the left side in 2006, and that was the big, big trouble area. So 2006 was a great year for me. I had about maybe a third of my pain left on the right side. Following surgeries took care of that in 2007 and 8. So we got me to the point where I was pain-free.
After undergoing procedures to treat the primary cause of pain on his left side, John returned home to his day-to-day routine. He remained pain-free for 11 years until a new condition developed, causing him serious discomfort.
In 2018, unfortunately, I started getting some pain early in the year down in my back. It immediately went to the right side and started down the leg and made it all the way down to the foot. I got on the telephone, called the Benatti Institute, and we went back and we did 2 more surgeries and got everything taken care of. Mid-surgery somewhere and ask you to move your leg this direction or that direction or flex your back to try to see if, can they get it to aggravate and reproduce your pain. And of course, if it doesn't, then they know that they've gotten it taken care of. You'd think that being awakened in surgery somehow would be creepy and weird. It's not creepy or weird. Basically, they're just asking you to say 1 of 3 words, back, leg, groin. And if you don't have to report any pain in any of those areas, well, then you're probably finished. In recovery, when, you had a little juice, you got your clothes back on, you're walking a little light on your feet. I mean, you were operated on. It's not silliness. It's real surgery. But when you walk without pain, it's an amazing feeling. You're not going to get this on an 8-inch vertical cut, but you can get this at Benatti. Your homework would be to walk for a mile, 45 minutes of walking. That's all they're asking you to do. Not only can you do it, you feel really good about it.
Now having great success with 2 additional targeted Benatti procedures, John knows for sure he made the right decision.
I could probably explain it better with a question. Would you rather have a gaping wound or a scratch? And that was basically the difference in the 2 offerings. An 8-inch vertical cut with a bunch of muscles just chopped up. I didn't sound like the way to go for me. Little 3/4-inch, 1-inch horizontal, what looks like scratches on your back. And it's not even exciting to show your scars to anybody. They're almost invisible. And the recovery turnaround, you can be back to work in a week or two.
John is back to doing his favorite activities and making preparations for the next chapter of his life.
I'm able to do the things that I had to give up before. I play music. Guitars are heavy. After about an hour having one of those hang around your neck, you wear down pretty bad. Not a problem anymore. The surgeries were great. I am, zero pain. I move better than probably most of the people that I work around and work with. I think I feel younger. Well, if you love pain, do what you're doing. If you're tired of it, give these people a call. They'll help you out. When somebody takes away the worst thing out of your life and gives you your life back, that's a beautiful, beautiful experience.